created a gridlock since 1809. Some word of myself. I have been grown up on the river, like my parents, grandparents, and their families as well. So I have inherited the fishing rights for this special for my mother's side. And also, I started my working career in the 60s, starting with this special fishing, as you see in the picture. The salary was 23 marks per 24 hours. It's translated to this currency, and it makes some hardly $2 per hour. But anyway, it's what tax free, so it's a good thing. And after that, I was involved in business life, involving in industrial automation business in international markets. And after that, I have retired and started okay, being a fisherman, as you see in the picture. And also been active in local, starting and initiating local development in our river valley. Okay, then let's start first. I would like to introduce the famous, most famous and delicious product of our house. So it's whitefish on the stick. It's roasted on open fire and salted afterwards with salt in water. And then you should enjoy it with actual water. I think it's a good description. And the delicious is not coming only from the cooking method. It's only also, I think that it's coming because of its feeling in salt water and coming to river migrate into sweet water. At least I tell that to my guests. So remember that I'm a fisherman, not a researcher. And I think we'll also prepare you this kind of dish if you find it, because the provision is not also that this kind of dish is meant responsibly. The only one I can prepare or cook. I will also share with you in my presentation about our whitefish and our culture. Then I will a little bit share with you the whitefish and our community, and then what we do to foster our cultural heritage in our river. First, maybe you all know where the Torne River is located. It's in North Europe. The Arctic Circle is crossing our river as well, and we are between Sweden and Finland. It's the biggest river in the North Europe, which is flowing free. So it's roughly 500 kilometers long, and flow is something 370 cubic meter per second up to 1,000 cubic meter per second. So it's flood is coming in the spring, and the flow is very strong in that time. The river valley roughly is home for 80,000 people. And okay, we speak Finnish and Swedish, but we also have our own common language. It's called Märkieli, and we have also common cultural background in the whole Torne Valley. And it's also the most peaceful border in the world. You can cross the border without noticing it that you are crossing the border. And I have many relatives on the other side of the river. For fishing, it's most important spawning river for salmon and migrating whitefish from the Baltic Sea. And the river has also to any other fish species. The whitefish is ascending roughly 80 kilometers from the sea up to here in Litornia or Patilakoski. And when the whitefish has been ascending about 20-25 kilometers from sea, it comes to the Kukkola Rapids, which I'm telling more to you about. There the tradition of fishing is named differently. The fishing method is originating from 1400. So, little bit the tools has been changed, material, but basic things are the same. You are looking after whitefish in the rapids. The successful fisherman needs three things to be good before he gets the fish. First thing is have a proper handmade tools, second is soft hands, and third is good luck. And here I have brought, I can show you the dinner. It's belonging to also 6 meter long hands, but you don't find it in the paper. And you are dipping down the river, and you need to have a soft hand because it's close to the rocky bottom, and you should not pass, but go by. And then you, when the fish comes, because you don't see it, you feel it in your fingers with the hand. It's a small preparation. You know when you are not getting it, when you are catching it, but anyway, you are feeling it. One could ask what kind of feeling it is. So, once I got good comparison, I'm not sure this is a good comparison, but one Swedish lady who is dip netting told me that when you get the salmon in your dip net, you have a similar feeling like the baby is sticking first time in the boat. So I don't know which way I learned, but now I have some idea. Well, what my wife thought that I have two kids. Also, you see that the river is wide to 300 meters, so the whitefish has a good opportunity to bite much also the fishermen. The second traditional fish method is the drift netting, but I'm concentrating on this drift netting this time. So, the river level is variating several meters during the summer. And so is the whitefish is changing the rules, swimming rules in the rapids as well. So we have a special dip netting pitch in the rapid which has been here several hundred years. So I have been advised for my grandfather where are and which level of river you should go there and so on. And when the handle is only 6 meters long, you need to do something to get the active fish in case you have a little bit different water level. So we are building bridges with very old fishery metal. They are wooden. Actually everything, and early days has been also are building the big netting places, the bridges, with same technology as the building. Many are just of experience of details, which way, which legs would be, how long, which one kind of wedge you should have in the rafter, and how you bring the rafter on the water, and because of the flow is very strong, and we break the iron doesn't last. So writing all the time is the structure, so special way to build them, and now let's we build it. For example, this bridge is taking from 20 guys to now.
Of culture.
Then a couple of words of whiteness and our community. The role of whiteness has changed a lot in the last tens of hundreds of years, but has been a key role in our community. First thing is, this has been that it's availability of food, availability of healthy food. So you know that it's a source of protein and omega 3 and so forth. After salt was introduced in 1200, it's inoculated year round use, so we have been salting fish for the winter time, and then we had better food year round. And also we have developed this traditional dishes as you. One is the roasted over fire, salted fish soup, and also smoked, and so forth. In addition to that food, this has been also important from economical side in the past. The annual cash from in our rabbits has been roughly 1500 kilos per season or more. And in the past, it has been even 50% of the income of the farmhouses. We have exported whitefish and salmon to the St. Petersburg, Stockholm, and Helsinki from our province. And also paid taxes for the society for that. Nowadays, I think that we are doing the same system than 100 years ago, but it's more social activity and recreation. If you meet our people in the village, the first question is not how the weather is. The first question is how about the catch. Next question is how about the level of the river? Maybe the weather is not so important. So it's basically the small talk and good to start with everyone. And then, okay, now there's also the tourist ask the same questions, how about the cats? And also this cat sail route is very popular, and then the whole village is coming together every night and so forth. And we are also celebrating the Ascent of Whitefish at the end of July. I don't know which role whitefish has had in this cross-border communication, but anyhow I know that there is a lot of cross-border marriages. I don't know whether the whitefish was the reason that the Swedish ladies went to South Sweden after better life. And then the Swedish men married the Finnish lady on the other side of the river. And I think Swedish Kukkola to have 80% of the houses have actually wife from Finnish side. And as you know, maybe that there's also on the river is time zone, so we have 1 hour difference in time between Sweden and Finland, and the Finnish people are waking up earlier. So that's, I think, in many houses you have a watch on the wall, and sometimes in Sweden side is also in Finnish time. Two reasons, maybe. You can earlier the work, or you can look who is designing in the house. Both are valid reasons. It's also been long time, also source of disputes. Always the fisherman up at the river is blaming the fisherman down the river, because he takes the fish home of his fish. I don't understand the logic even I'm here. So also the fish awareness has been very important part of the identity in our village. For example, within the one coat of arm of one municipality, as three wives. So that's very known. So that's the actually what is our heritage, but there has also some threats today. It's not self-evident that our culture will sustain and living fishing culture. The first thing you have seen is, excuse me, the statistic in the left side. That's our catch statistic in Kukkola Rapids. So the conclusion is that the whitefish estimating is delayed 1 month in 30 past years. And the medium size has gone down from roughly 400-500 grams to 300 grams per year. So it has changed lots of threats. So if you had you don't have a whitefish in the river, you don't have a fisherman, and then you don't have tourists. It's a simple thing. The other thing is also that maybe happening in everywhere else in the world, that agriculture, the part of share of agriculture in our infrastructure has changed. In the 1920 we had 70% becoming income from the agriculture, nowadays less than 4%. In our village we had 50 houses delivering milk to the dairy. In the past. Now we have one actually farm maintaining the sheep. So you understand how different it is to transfer the tradition to the young generation. So it's not self-evident that you take your son and say that go to Tipnet and that's your turn. Also, that's why the young people are maybe not easy to get in into this today. Also we have some troubles in authorities in that sense that even state owned companies are letting our traditional rights time to time and we need to fight for them. So that's in my mind to say. But we have also opportunities, the growing ecotourism and the food trend, so what we can utilize. For example, this picture in the other side, this is from Swedish side, and they have a tourism and they employ 40 people in the summertime, and the catch from Swedish side is 5,000 kilos of mostly. The price of the fish is tenfold. So, we decided then to do something about this. To foster our white fish and our culture. So we started to discuss global fisherman and fish association and on the river and then we succeed to establish initially a big project funded by EU. And we are very proud of that, and the fishing association on the river, they are 25 of that. They are major funder of the part of the private funding in our project. So it's 3 years that we can look later little bit what is the content of the summer life. The one area is that the researchers are seeking transfers to our questions. Why this whitefish is coming to later than earlier, why is it smaller and so on. And because we have built this project together, they have also good support, strong support from our people. Then I said that one focus group is the young people in our work banks. So we decided that we need to digitalize our traditions and heritage in online form that our young kids can get easy knowledge about it, even guidance about how to make this big bank and so forth. And it belongs also some courses for dignetting or also making dignet. You may find some in YouTube and so forth, and I will comment with this poster some films or videos in my laptop if you want to look closer. And we have also agreed with local school authorities that the kids between 11 to 13 at school will have an integrated program in the biology and those relevant topics from our biology and nature, our river, and as well our culture. And we also have invited them every autumn to our rabbit to look at and be interested in this. You cannot taste the white fish on the online, but the third part is we think that we need to support this growth of ecotourism with our living culture. You know, if you buy this white fish, you buy food. Well, it is very delicious food. But if you come to us, you fish itself, you put on stick itself and clean the fish, and you roast in itself and salting itself, and then you eat itself. It's called experience. And the price, you can't even price it that experience. You can never get it anywhere else. But that's the direction what we did. Also when we do this build the bridges, we have maybe not so many voluntary workers in our staff, so we have opportunity to say that our tourists, and they pay $1,000 per day, they can take part of our building things and take the wooden bars to us that we can take the imported board. So you need to change your point of view with this, to chasing this experiences and utilize it. We're also building the web guarding system in making these videos and so forth. You can touch with QR code and look closer to the clarification of this area. We are also there every day explaining and describing these things, but there's so many questions that we also need to help from this digital world. So we also think that we can prepare or cook the white fish in a different way and that way make it more global. So maybe I find some recipes also here when I'm sitting here. So at last, I think summary of my presentation that what we do, we think we do need to foster our white fish and living fishing culture in next decade. I said we need to have sustainable whitefish stock and salmon in our river. That's the first reason. That's why the researchers are working. We need to tempt the younger generation to enjoy and appreciate our culture. We need to leverage our culture and develop ecotourism based on the older type. I'm younger seniors in our official association. The senior guy is the 80s. They don't think that it's the right thing yet. Also, we need to borderless cooperation, all stakeholders, in municipalities, fishermen, local people, entrepreneurs, and so on. And I think this project is so very good that if we integrate culture and the fishing research, we have all support. And our next goal is basically to get this our cultural heritage on UNESCO list. So that's the way we can also protect it in the future. One river and two countries. It's excellent there. So last I think that you can see that our graphics has actually declined also in the autumn at this time. And I think that these kind of seminars are important to share the knowledge that we can take benefit also that know that how we can read now our white window so that it is suitable in the future. And maybe you could have this kind of seminar in the future